Here at Anthony Franco's, we take our food preparation very seriously. With the freshest ingredients delivered daily from the markets at Hunts Point and the finest pasta from one of Brooklyn's oldest pasta houses, we have a large variety of specialty pizzas, pastas, and sandwiches, along with a cozy dining area for your special events. With two great locations, 556 Route 17 North Paramus and 128 East Main Street, Ramsey. Call 201-447-3999 in Paramus and 201-238-8000 in Ramsey. Give us a call. We'd love to hear from you. And as always, free delivery.
Hey, what's going on? Mikey McSee, the Wild Irishman, Joey B.
Hello.
What's going on out there in ACFL land?
Yeah.
Well, Mike, Mother's Day, did you take your wife out someplace nice to eat?
No, my wife actually had to work. So I worked in the morning, she worked in the afternoon, but it's all right.
Yeah. Well, all right. Mother's Day was a great holiday, but it did cause quite a few shakeups.
Yes, it did.
In the league this week. And
yeah.
I'm telling you, there some changes that happened in the standings, and
a little bit,
and I predicted one of those changes.
You did,
but I had nothing to do with the outcome of the game.
No.
So you can't blame the show or me for this, right?
See, whenever you make a prediction,
it comes true.
You must have the influence. These people were right. You can't do it.
And where do we tell? Where do we show them what the prediction was?
Yeah,
that's going to be great. But let's, Mike, let's start it off with the 6-on-6 AFC flag,
right.
And we had a good one. Right at the top.
Yeah, it depends on what you like. But this was a great game. This was a beatdown. This really was. The second half, Bruins completely owned. Shut them down.
Well,
they didn't score a point.
Of course, we're talking about the Bruins and the Bears
game,
one of the bigger games of the week. And I like to read the board because I like to see the communication between the teams. And, AJ, you had a great post when you said, well, it's a regular season game. And we're really not going to show each other too much.
I'll tell you.
We're going to save it for the playoffs. Well, I don't think the Bruins could have done any more than what they did. And if they can, then I underrated the Bruins.
Yeah.
And I've underrated them a few times. But, boy, you shut me up this week.
Yeah.
That was a really big, great game you played against the Bears.
This
really
looks
good.
Like Bruins of old. I mean, and the Bears, they were coming after it. You see the first half. It was 14-13 at the half. I mean, right there, Jim chasing AJ down for sacks, everything, interceptions, you name it, it was in the first half. Nice tight game.
So now, you were at the game, you filmed the game, right? Just for the sake of clearing something up, most of the Bears were there. The Bears weren't missing any significant personnel?
Not that I know of. It looked like all the same guys are out there. But the Bruins were missing people, missing some key people, you know, some key receivers. Bruins didn't have Thurman out there, missing one other guy. His name escapes me. I know he plays on on Orange Lantern. But so AJ was missing two skill guys, and still, they put it on.
Wow, and you know what, Tebow? I know you're out there watching. They shut us both up this week, the Bruins did.
Now it's I Love the Blazers. That's his new name.
Well, and now that that turned out to be probably, competitive-wise, a better game than the Bruins-Bears game was.
Oh, my God. I think the we'll get into that when we get in the NFC. But, that Blazers-Yambi game was probably the best I've ever seen in this league to date.
You know what? And I got to say, I mean, you know, I keep trying to bury the Lightning. You keep bringing them back to life. And now you look at the standings, the Lightning are 4-1.
Yeah, they jumped over the Bears. They're in second place.
Well, now they have to play the Bears.
They do.
Am I correct? So that's the game there. The Bucks hanging around at 4-2.
There you go.
Most of these teams have two games left. The Bruins have three games left.
Yeah.
But they've got the tiebreaker over the Bears.
Wow.
7-1 might win this division. Although, again, and AJ, don't pass out when you hear this, I don't think the Lightning have the horses to beat the Bruins. They may score some points, but, again, I still believe the defense is going to
If the Bruins played like they did on Sunday, my goodness. And like I said, it was that little Konecki folds out.
Oh, you know? Kanacki. I tell you, the guy.
Huge plays. One was a touchdown for that. They looked great. This was such a good game.
I tell you something about Kanacki, and I've been watching him for a long time, and I always tease him when I draw one of their games.
Yeah.
This is one tough little mother, man.
Yeah.
I mean, he'll block guys twice his size.
And then just
he'll
sneak
catch
out.
Balls. And, you know, he gets lost out there.
Yeah.
He gets lost.
Gets those little legs moving, boom. And
I'm
he's downfield, touchdown.
And the guy he's all hard, plays hard all the time, Kanacki does. And it's just a real, real good guy. Balls deep at 3-2.
Yep.
That's the last team above 500 in the division, no matter what. Justice League, Deep Threats, Watchmen, not this season.
Hey, never know what could happen in the playoffs.
No, I'll tell you what. You know what? Maybe if I predict one of them will win the game,
maybe
something will happen.
Then
right?
We know.
Yeah, then we know that it's true. Let's switch over to the NFC, Mike. And we just brought up that game, Sam's Taxi Blazers against the Yombies in overtime.
Yeah. Wow. Wow. If you haven't seen the game, you got to watch this game. It was unbelievable. Yombies coming back. They needed two touchdowns just to tie it up. At the end of the half. Or at the end of the game, with still, there was about 6 seconds left. They could have gone in to win it. Ugh, heartbreaker.
Well, now you said that. You told me that there was one player on Sam's Taxi Blazers that really stuck out.
Yeah.
I'm going to let you.
Barry was just.
Barry. And this was, Barry's a great athlete anyway.
Oh, my goodness. This was just a highlight reel for him, it seemed. You know, picking off passes, blowing past Lagunas and scoring touchdowns. I mean, these guys are good.
Well, the Yombies put up 35 points.
Yeah.
They put up 35 points.
But I'll tell you what, watching that game, the Yombies had to scrape for those 35 points. Seems like the Blazers were just like, we'll score 35 today.
Well, they still have that young kid playing quarterback,
too.
That
kid's got an arm, too.
Can throw
putting it on people.
Yeah.
And it's good when you have fast receivers and they get behind the defense. Yeah, just loft it up.
I'm telling you. And then the Nexus.
Those guys.
Come back with their second in a row.
Yeah, look at this.
Over the nice snatch.
53 points.
53 points they put up. So the Yombies may have created a monster here.
Yeah.
And they've got to be careful because the Yombies are at 3-3. Nexus has three losses already.
Yeah.
They have the tiebreaker over the Yombies. The Yombies right now are in fourth place. They might draw.
Wow.
The Yombies might draw the Venom or Nexus in a first round game.
Wow.
which could be very, very interesting. Nice snatch. Transcend Titans just
hang in there,
fellas. Season. Of course, at the top, we have.
There we are. Always, right? I mean, that's where they hang out.
Buck City Breed hanging in there at 5-1. The Buck City Breed, they are a good
team. That's a really
good team. They have yet to play the Taxi Blazers, I believe. So the last couple of weeks.
Yeah.
You're going to have a lot of shifting in the middle.
I'll tell you, we've been talking a lot about the B-League, how great the B-League. Why haven't we been talking about this 6-on-6? These guys have just snuck up. Look at this. Like I said, just in this NFC, All-Stars, Buck City, Yombies, Blazers. I mean, these are going to be some great games.
In the playoffs? Yeah,
you're going to have a lot of playoffs. I mean, that could be looking at the semifinals right there.
Well, I mean, if you take a look at the seedings at where they're at now, I would say the first three teams,
right,
All-Stars, Buck City, and Sam's Taxi Blazers, should not have a difficult time in a first round.
No, they shouldn't.
Should not. If the Yombies don't advance, and I don't see how they can, they're two games behind with two games left.
One against Buck City, right?
And one against Buck City.
Mm.
So, I mean, even winning that game will not get them over Buck City.
No.
They'll still be a loss behind. Yeah. So, like I said, if the Yombies draw the Venom or Nexus again, now the Venom is one of those teams you don't want to play them.
No, good quarterback.
That's the Jordan Spieth lookalike.
Yeah, that kid's got an arm too and accurate.
Yeah, they got some athletes
team.
On there.
Yeah.
So that that 4-5 game might be the best game of the first round.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, man.
It might be the best game of the first round. At any rate, the All-Stars just sitting there biding time.
Yeah, just waiting.
You know, they've got my man Menner on the sideline
there. Yeah,
nobody picks up a kicking tee faster than Menner.
Hey,
he gets out there. He's a good guy. I love Menner. All right. And now, before we get into the B division, we're going to take this break and feature a new sponsor, Steve Sizzlin' Steaks, who's sponsoring the field goal kicking contest.
Right.
And listen, guys, I don't know if you've ever been there or ever heard of them, but these steaks are like $45, $50 each. It's dinner for two. So it could be like $130, $140 dinner for the guy with the biggest foot.
Mm.
You know, and You're going to have a holder.
Yeah, man.
Too. You're not going to be able to kick it from a tee. So you have to have a holder. And as a matter of fact, Mike, I think this week we're going to actually put the sign-up thing on the website.
Okay.
Yeah, put it up there and let's see how many guys we here want to sign up.
Sounds good.
And the actual rules, Dave JT and I have discussed the format of how it's going to be. And it's going to be pretty cool. So this is our first word from a new sponsor, Steve's Sizzling Steaks. We'll be right back.
As restaurants come and go, it is rare to find an establishment like Steve's Sizzling Steaks. Steve's has focused on excellent food, comfortable ambiance, and a friendly staff. Times sure have changed since Steve's first opened their doors, but what hasn't changed is the family atmosphere that makes Steve's so special. Open 7 days a week, Sunday through Thursday, 11:30 a.m. to 10 p.m., and Friday and Saturday, 11:30 a.m. to 11 p.m. Located at 620 Route 17 South in Carlstadt, New Jersey, or call 201-438-9677 for your reservation.
You made me hungry with that commercial.
All right. That was all Steve.
You made me hungry, man.
All right.
Well, anyhow, let's get to the NFC. And I tell you, a team that we have not given a lot of love to. The Kodiaks, Jerry and the Kodiaks.
Yeah, they've been pretty quiet. I mean, it's a quiet 5-1, but they've been pretty quiet.
You know, I mean, and they totally destroyed the scoreless Warheads. I mean, you know, I really feel for you, because I know your guys go out there and they play hard every week, but man,
you know, maybe we could chalk that one up to Mother's Day. Not everyone there. Well, you know, I mean, you know, some of these scores may be skewed a little bit because of that.
That's true.
But still. Gum.
Man, can't even put one up.
Yeah.
You know, and I got it, but Jerry's not a rub it in kind of guy.
No.
You know,
yeah, I mean, like you said, quietly, they're 5-1, and we haven't really even been mentioning them.
You know, and their one loss, the Kodiaks' one loss, I believe came to the Bankers.
I believe so.
And we're going to talk about them in a little bit, too.
Another team jumping up in the standings.
But the Kodiaks, guys are at 5-1. The Hawkeyes, who had...
Keep it rolling. Squeaked it out.
9 or 10 guys.
Yeah.
They had, and Bishop, I said I'd give Bishop a shout out because I was doing the game right next to their field.
Okay.
Ran the ball like a madman. And Bishop had a huge game. Josh had a huge game for the Hawkeyes. They were able to, 18-6.
18-6.
But it was a win.
I mean, yeah, well, comparatively, you know, the rest of their other scores, they've been putting up.
But they were
30,
but they were
points.
Missing a lot of people.
Yeah,
they were
still,
missing a lot, and that was a Mother's Day thing.
But they did what they had to do.
Yes.
Even though they were missing, they got the job done.
Well, now, and we just mentioned the Bankers, right?
Yeah. Yep.
I'll tell you, I was told before the game, watch our quarterback. Watch our quarterback.
New guy,
right? His name is Matt. Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm telling you something. This guy is the real deal. He first three plays over the top on the Wolfgang.
Really?
And I mean, flick of the wrist, touchdown. Yeah, and then he plays safety on defense. So this guy can play. The Bankers are 4-2, and their two losses were very close games.
Right.
So this is a team, this is a lookout team for me.
Okay.
So keep your eye on this team, especially this quarterback, because this kid can play.
Bankers now.
And the Rodney Dangerfields of the
flag B,
ACFL,
right?
The New Jersey Lions.
Yeah.
Managed to put up 12 points, and that was good enough to beat the Sons of Anarchy.
There you go. Jumping up to fourth place.
Yeah. 3-3.
And never getting any love.
Never. I mean, they are like, you know. And there's a nice bunch of – and they were missing a lot of guys, too.
Yeah.
They had a guy, a quarterback, that didn't want to be there. You know, this was the old wing T formation. The quarterback could drop back, take a look, and just head for the quickest hole.
There we go.
But they were able to put up 12, where the Sons of Anarchy were only able to put up 6.
Hey, and that's all you got to do, put up a little more points.
These
but look at the middle of this division, 3-3.
Now, how about the Bulldogs falling to 3-3?
Ooh.
Getting beat by the Patriots, who we'll talk about.
Patriots
here they are.
They needed a win.
They needed a win.
2-3 weeks?
They were under fire. Their offense had been really not good.
Getting beat down at home.
And now I got to believe that some of the Bulldogs weren't there.
Yeah.
That would be my guess. I don't want to take nothing away from the Patriot win.
Right.
But again, we really don't know who was there, who wasn't there, and
but hey, win's a win.
Yeah.
Like I said, the guys showed up, they played the game, they had what they had. That's how you gotta win.
But now you look at the first three teams
right
in the NFC, and I think they're pretty locked in. I don't think the Bankers are gonna go below. I don't know if they played the Bulldogs yet.
Right.
These are things that we'll know, like I said, next week when everything, after this week's
pops
games,
out, hopefully schedule will be up.
We'll know what's going on. And again, at this sitting, we don't know what games we've been playing this week.
No.
So, at any rate, though, the Warheads are 2-4. Remember, they were
2-0. Oh, goodness, yeah.
And they dropped four straight. The Patriots are at 500. The Bulldogs were at 3-1 2 weeks ago. And they lost that close game to the Hawkeyes. So now they've kind of leveled off at 500. So, but the thing about it is, Mike, any one of these teams that's 3-3
exactly
could have their day.
Bankers slip up one, they slip up next week. If one of those teams are playing the Bankers next week, they win. That's a couple 4-3 teams right there.
Yeah.
Boom, boom.
But I tell you what, this is the first time I see the Bankers play this year.
Yeah.
They got some
looking good, huh?
Yeah, they got some athletes. This quarterback, I'm telling you, his name is Matt. And,
watch out.
Watch out for Matt. And chews tobacco, too.
While he plays?
Yeah, while he plays. You can see that, unless he's got a toothache.
Yeah.
But, watch out for the Bankers, guys.
Big league chew or something.
They are my they're my team to watch in
this
division.
Okay, Bankers.
All right, let's flip it over.
AFC.
Here's my prediction. I had predicted last week that the Goons would not go undefeated, and they lost.
Ugh.
So what I did was I called them all and told them that the game was canceled, not to go to the field, so that I could say on this show, my prediction came true again.
The influence you have.
The influence, it's amazing. I'm going to make it rain. When we leave here tonight, it's going to be raining.
Yeah. It was a shame that this game had to, that they couldn't field a team, because this was going to be a great game.
Now, I know that
it was going to get filmed.
They had requested a time change in the game. The league could not accommodate them there.
Mm.
And ultimately forfeited to J.D. Core Training, who now inherits the top spot.
Boom.
With the tiebreaker over the Goons.
Yeah.
But here's a team I want to talk about. Now, the Warriors had a big win. They really, I think they scored 42
41
points.
41-6 over the Wolfpack.
Over the Wolfpack. So the Wildcats.
Wildcats, yeah.
Have jumped up to 4-2.
Jumping up to fourth place right now.
Team at 4-2. Now,
they
squeaked. Just squeaked one out. I think it was a one-point win.
Against the Kings, yeah.
Against the Kings. Woo. Now, again, that might have been a personnel issue.
Right.
You don't know. But you show up with a team, whether you're missing guys or not, you're expected to win.
That's right.
And the Trojans now at 3-3. They've leveled off the Kings at 2-4, and the rest of the league, the rest of the division, not this year.
Yeah.
Not this season. But I'm starting to watch the Wildcats now. And that's the other team. Now, I had the watch team in the NFC. Here's the watch team in the NFC. Watch the Wildcats. They're starting to get it together. They got some athletes on that team. Jimmy and Jack. The twins there are really playing. Well, they always play hard too.
That's right.
And they're keeping their heads under control, which is another.
That's good.
It's another issue for them.
That's a huge thing.
They get hot.
Yeah.
You know, and but watch out for them. The Warriors, the Goons, and JD. Now I don't know where JD Core goes from here with this record.
Right.
So if they win their last two games, they're division winners.
Yeah, that's it.
Period.
Yeah.
And they would get the Locos on the first round.
Yeah.
Which. I would think they should beat them. But once again, the 4-5 game in here could be very, very interesting.
Yeah.
Because you'll have Wildcats, team, or the Trojans.
Yeah.
Or if that flip-flops, it'll still be team, and the Wildcats, or the Trojans.
What's your team right now? I'm Wildcats.
So I'm telling you, it's getting... It's going to get sticky. I think both B Flag League divisions are going to get very sticky before it's over. I can't wait for the playoffs.
Yeah.
Because of the what is the baseball players like to call it when they say everything is equal? What's the word I'm looking for?
I have no idea.
I can't find it. If you know the word, put it on an email. I can't. Parity.
There
it is. The parity in both of these divisions.
Yes. You know what? You're all right.
Yeah. It really is. The top teams. I can't. It wouldn't shock me if any one of them beat any one of them. Right.
Woo.
And I saw Shono. I told Shono I'd give him a shout out on the air. Big game, Shono. says, I get such a kick out of him walking to the line, pulling up his pants all the time. One of these times he's going to forget, what and his secret will be out.
Flip.
All right. So, oh, touch. And I got a great touch story for you here. I do. I have a great touch story.
It's a family show. I don't want to bleep
it. No,
anything. Oh, touch league.
Okay. Touch league. Two guys that play on the Bankers.
Okay.
Also are part of the A-team in touch.
A-team. Okay.
Now, in the game that I was doing, they had mentioned to me that I had said on the air that I think the Flight Boys are probably going to go undefeated. They told me candidly, they said, hey, we haven't been with the team for a lot of games. We've only played one game so far.
Okay.
We're going to be there today, and the Flight Boys are going down. And they were really close with
they
that.
They were really close, huh?
Because the Flight Boys had to score two touchdowns
in the last minute
of play to pull this game out.
And they pulled it out.
And they go to 6-0.
My goodness, I'm
starting to think that this just might be their year.
Maybe.
This is just their year. Everything's going right for them.
They're
everything. Dominating. But right below, hovering right below is 5-0, are the Hawks, who also had a big win.
Yes, they did.
This week. So they're not going anywhere.
They took down the Rebels. Your team knocking on the door. Rebels were right there.
All I said was
you said they were knocking.
Maybe knocking. Maybe they rang the doorbell.
They're still in fourth place.
But they had a signature win the week before, right?
They also then went up against, one of the top teams.
I understand that.
But
was the game even close? Let's see, we got scores here. Was the game even close?
Yeah, 28-10.
All right, so, I mean, they played hard.
They
always play hard.
Yeah.
But that would have put them at 4-1.
Yeah.
And then we would have had to talk about them.
Yes.
A little bit more seriously.
Still there, though.
The quasi All-Stars.
Franchise, as I call them.
4-2. You call them the franchise. I call them the quasi. They're 4-2. I don't think they're going to win the division or have any shot. I think the only threat to the Flight Boys is the Hawks. And that game's got to be coming up.
It's got to be.
I mean,
maybe Flight Boys have off this week, and then
maybe they have a bye.
They're
nine
last
teams.
Week.
Nine teams in the league, and they are the. Well, there's a couple of teams. The Rebels only have five games.
Okay.
Grimaces only have five games.
Yeah.
A-team, Rockamore. Yeah, they're off this week. I got to believe the Flight Boys are off.
Then go up against the Hawks.
Ooh. Oh, man, that's going to be cool because the Hawks. Depends on who the Hawks draw. Now, I'd like to see the Hawks draw the All-Stars this week, All-Stars, or the Rebels.
That will be good.
Or even the A-team because the A-team, they got to feel like a knife in the back. You have a two-touchdown lead.
With a
minute left, and you lose the game. And they were ready to get on the board and say, boys, we told you we were going to. Flight Boys, 17,
baby.
Number 17, I'm wearing your jersey on the air. If you're in a championship game, when we do the show, I will have number 17 jersey on for you. But the Hawks, 5-0, no real major changes here.
No.
The two undefeated teams remain undefeated.
Yep.
The All-Stars hanging around in third. The Rebels
still there.
Half
Militia.
A game back. Militia. Do a lot of talking, but they're a 500 club at 6-6.
Yeah.
So, got to do a little less yakking and more playing.
Yep. Took down the Grimaces, though, pretty handily.
Well, the Grimaces had a win the week before.
Right.
And
they had the replacements
Now they're grimacing.
Yes, they are. Yeah.
And last but certainly not least this week, the A-League. And, you said something before we went on the air, and I'm wondering how many other people feel the same way.
Right.
Because of the competitiveness of the other divisions.
Right.
Because of the athleticism in the other divisions, and we're talking all of them.
Right.
You think the A League this season was a little blasé?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean,
you get the opinion. I hear a lot of people talking about the A League. It's still the most prestigious division.
Yes. Oh, yes.
In the
ACFL. It just seems a little ho-hum this year.
You know, because there's been so many things. The Diablos at 5-0, I mean, they are cruising.
Yeah.
Have they had a close game this season?
That's a tough team to play.
You know, the All-Stars are 5-0. They're hanging around. East Orange Rec, on the benefit of a forfeit.
Right.
Is at 4-2.
Shakers is actually the surprising team so far, I think.
Well, they got out of the box, what, 0-2?
Yeah, 0-2. So they've rattled
four
off
straight. Four in a row.
You know, that's pretty good.
HOB, up and down.
Yeah.
Win one, lose one.
Express
2-0, lost those two games by 2 points.
Yeah, and then they had
Then they got blasted, but they had personnel issues.
Yeah, they only had nine guys. I mean, not even nine at kickoff.
Then again, you could say that just about anybody. Brick City Bulldogs having a real tough year. Hanging in every game.
Hanging in there. Hey, they're showing up. Good for them.
And the Canes not being there
I
don't know. It
just doesn't seem. It seems kind
of. The Diablos are walking through this division. The All-Stars have had a couple of close games.
Yeah. They're
still 5-0.
Yeah.
You know, but
10-2 against HOB this week.
You know, I watched that championship game again.
Nice. That was a good game.
It was a great game.
That was a good game.
Good game. Keep looking at those fourth down.
You know, and the way it's heading, though, I mean, it may end up that way. We may get a rematch.
Now, the Shakers could be one of the upsetters. The HOB is always capable of an upset.
Yes.
You know, and I don't know. It just doesn't have the fire.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't feel as competitive as in past years, you know, when everybody was kind of at the top.
You had one or two games separating everyone.
Yeah, like everyone at the top. Those four teams at the top were fighting. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah. Oh, I can't wait to see that.
I mean, they're still all playing hard.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
They're still all playing hard.
I don't
hard,
know. It just seems.
But the luster seems a little bit off.
Seems I've seen this movie before. You know what I mean?
I mean, and if the Diablos walk through the playoffs, now, I'm not saying they're going to.
That's a tough team. I mean, they had Ronnie throwing the ball.
Yeah, everybody throwing.
You know what I mean? They have basically four quarterbacks on that team, and all of them can scramble from the pocket.
Now, athletically, the All Stars and the Shakers have athletes.
Yes, they do.
East Orange Rec has athletes. HOB has athletes.
Right.
The Express has athletes. It's just going to matter of who steps up at the right time.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, could the Diablos lose a game to one of these teams? Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. Maybe.
But
yeah, maybe.
So you're a maybe guy.
I mean, that's a good team, man. Well,
All we can do is watch it for the next 3 weeks.
That's it.
See where the seedings take everybody.
That's it.
And go from there.
Second season.
And you know what? We said that about every division.
Yeah.
If this happens in this seeding, if this happens in another seeding,
It's going to be
a great stretch run.
Two more weeks left in the season.
It's going to be a great stretch run.
Maybe one or two teams moving around.
Flip-flop.
You know?
Anyway, we'll be here for Mikey McSee, the Wild Irishman, Joey B., voice of the ACFL. And I had to get my summer cut. And, you know, I had one guy come up to me on the sidelines of a game I was doing, and he goes, yeah, this is a true story. I'm not kidding. He says, you know, I hear they give you a lot of garbage about your hair in the posting. And I go, yeah. He says, well, you know, I read that stuff, so I take it off my head. I think, yeah, go ahead.
Gotcha.
And he gave it a tug.
Okay.
Hard tug, dragged me five
yards. There you
yards.
Go. Boom.
But anyway,
physical
guys,
physical.
Have a great week. And this Sunday, we'll be back at it again. The Wild Irishman and his roving camera. Never know where he's going to be. And we'll see you next week on This Week in the ACFL. Good night, everybody.